How's it going, guys? So, the video you guys are about to watch is actually a bit choppy. I kind of suck at this audio thing. But it's filled with a bunch of really raw emotion, so I decided to actually keep it and post it for you guys. Don't be too mad at me, and don't be too harsh on the videos. If anything's lost in translation, I'll just re-record everything all over again, and they'll have less emotion to them. But I hope you guys enjoy them, and peace.
So, bullies. Bullies are really, I like to think of them as emotional dust bunnies. They just, like, take up space, they tumble around, and at that time, they're trying to figure out the world, and they lash out, be it because of home situations or an insecurity situation. That's why they're mean, be it to you or just anyone. Now, how I dealt with bullies and how I wish and hope that in the future bullies are dealt with, explain to them. Now, how I used to deal with bullies is I used to fucking fuck them up, because I was taught that how you deal with a bully is standing up to them. Because once they figure out that they can't fucking beat you, or they can't just fuck with you without repercussion, then they just back off. Because why fuck with the guy that's gonna punch them back in their fucking mouth when you can just fuck with some other timid asshole? Now, that resulted in a lot of suspensions, a lot of write-ups, a lot of pink slips, some detention, because I, from bullying started for me when I was in second grade. Now, this person just didn't like me. Some reason I started school early. Grandmother was a teacher, so, and seeing as my birthday fell December the 18th, I started school early by American school standards. So I was in kindergarten when I was 2. Yeah. So I was in kindergarten when I was 2. Technically 3, I would be that year, but I was 2. So, when I got to second grade, I'm the smallest kid. And that resulted in people having to pick on me. So, what I found at that time was intimidation was my greatest ally. What did I do? I ripped people's buttons off their shirt and I ate. Weird, right? Now, I'm not saying guys go on and just fucking just rip entire fucking articles and just start fucking ingesting it, but like, I intimidated the bullies that I, you know, that bullied me, and thereby they wanted to make me friends with them, because if I intimidated them, then I was intimidating to other people, right? So for a time, I used to roll with bullies. Bullies just don't know what they actually. Now let's go on to the home environment. Like, bullies that bully people because of or because they're being bullied at home. There is a higher entity that either demeans their intelligence, demeans them physically because they're bigger than them, or they can intimidate them, and them as a child can't do anything, so they go to school and they intimidate them. I'm here to say to every single bully. Bro, stop. It is so much easier to get people to like you for you without bullying. You don't need to intimidate people to actually get them into your corner. Because the people that you intimidated that you think are in your corner really hate the fuck out of you. They will stop at nothing to see you stabbed in the back. And that's not true friendship. So if anybody like bullies anybody today, stop. Stop for your progression in life and the people that you bully. Because you stress their life out as much as your life is stressed out. And I understand misery loves company, but if you see people that are happy, don't get mad. Befriend them. Because you're only as good as the people that you surround yourself with. I understand that it's not as easy to, if you've been bullying people, to go back and be like, oh man, now I'm Mr. Happy-Go-Lucky, I'm sorry I took your lunch money, or I'm sorry that I beat you up that one. But because trusts don't work that way, and there's consequences for your action, just befriend for you. Be nice to that person. Say sorry. Apologize to the people that bully. If the number of bullies that opened up to me after I intimidated them were open to me when they were doing their bullying before I actually got into their crew, I wouldn't have seen that part of the world, nor would they be unhappy. Like, I learned things about, like, life and the reason why they, like, feel so insecure about themselves. Like, I would have loved to, like, have somebody just come up to me and be like, you know what, I'm sorry, man, for, like, sorry guys for pushing you down those steps, I'm sorry for pushing you in the yard, I'm sorry for, like, throwing that ball at your head, or whatever. I'm sorry for saying those things, those hurtful things. And they just explained their situation. We'd be the best of friends. Like, the world still has bullies in it. Like, when you get older, bullying does not stop. And it's sad. And that's why I say stop. Because you don't have to perpetuate what the world has around. In lots of ways, in many ways, the world is like school. Except there's no teachers. You're all self-taught. When I was in school, we paid for lunch. In the world, I pay for lunch. In the world, I had to get up early and go to work. I was going to school. School was my work. I did schoolwork, and I had to wake up early for that. At work, I am met with people that have different types of relationship ideals, moral ideals, come into work with an emotional state that could be good or bad. When I was in school, I dealt with these people and we called them bullies. If bullying is changed, or like the idea around opening up to another individual, and I understand that's hard, but trusting another individual with your innermost, like, fears, like, learning who that is and then opening up to them about your life so therapeutic and helps a lot. It is the on the list of the quickest ways to actually be happier, because you're not only holding these burdens on yourself. Now someone else knows about these things and is holding up this metaphorical rock with you that you call emotion, call a emotional state of. Stop the bullying, guys. Stop it now. You're in high school, elementary school, middle school. Take these words and apply them. If you aren't a bully, try to befriend that bully. Could sit here and be like, oh man, it's so fucking, it's fucking crazy. And if I heard that shit when I was in fucking 10th grade, I'd fucking unsubscribe and like fucking like debunk anything that future me had to say as well. Because I'm not going to sit here and tell you to fucking go up to a bully and be like, bro, I understand how you are, but because like they're emotionally unstable, and that's why I made the say to bullies first. And I'm not going to sit here and be like, don't fault them for their actions, because every person, every individual should be held accountable for their actions. That's why we have laws. That's why we have an entire judicial system. So I'm just saying, understand. It's like when a parent lashes out on you, and or a parent lashes out on a significant other because they had a bad day. It doesn't make it right, but it should be understood. Compassion. Togetherness. These are the two things that we actually need in this life to come closer together. Along with not seeing each other as colors and just a race of people, because in the entire like animal kingdom, animals don't see each other as colors. There's no white on gray or black wolf like prejudice. There's no polar bear against grizzly bear prejudice. There's no deer, there's no fucking mouse on rat prejudice. A rodent's a rodent. Two different snakes can inhabit the exact same area. Two different spiders can inhabit the exact same area because they see each other as species. And we are Homo sapiens. Humans. The human species. Guys, we come in different colors and hues because that's how the world works. Plants come in different colors and hues. That shouldn't cloud our judgment in who we deal with, nor should it dictate how we're going to actually deal with another person, because that's just small-minded to more of the same. It makes life stressful for another. It stops another person from being happy in it, which we're all trying to perpetuate. Happiness. You want to be happy, so does everyone else in the world. So by you helping someone else be happy, you're providing yet another bridge for yourself to be happy. That's all I got for today. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Peace.
I've been watching.